How do I tell if an attachment is a virus? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a very common question I get. Is it possible to tell if someone has sent you an email with a virus attached without opening the attachment? The short answer is not with 100% certainty, no. There are absolutely some steps you can and probably should take to stack the deck in your favor, but ultimately there's no way to prove a negative, right? I can't prove that it's not a virus. But first, I want to be clear about what it means to open an attachment. Downloading and opening are two different things. Downloading the attachment to your computer is safe. Right-click on the attachment and use Save As. Or save, whatever makes sense. That way, the file will exist on your computer, but whatever is contained within has not been activated, has not been looked at, has not been opened. And that's what opening is. Opening is running the attachment or opening the attachment in whatever program normally uses or opens that kind of attachment. And all of those techniques, opening the file, causes software to be run on your computer. Downloading does not. Downloading does not run anything on your computer. It simply copies the file from wherever it is to your computer. Opening the file causes something to be run. And it's that something that's being run that can be used for malicious intent. So, step one, download the file. Step two, well, I'm going to show you. I'm going to fire up Windows File Explorer here and look at my downloads folder. Now I've got a bunch of different things here. Let's go ahead and assume that somebody sent me this VeraCrypt setup program. I actually downloaded it from a safe site, but even if you're downloading, this technique applies. So I'm going to right-click on this file. And in Windows 10, the option I want will already be on this pop-up menu. In Windows 11, we need to say show more options, because in this case, we're going to scan with Microsoft Defender. Poof. Now, it's going to scan the one file. Notice that it is reporting malware. However, this is actually malware that is elsewhere on my machine. It's actually malware in the junk mail folder of Outlook. That so far I've been unable to get rid of, actually. It's not doing any harm there, but it simply exists, and Windows Defender is doing its job and telling me that it's there. More importantly, though, you'll notice that there are no reports of anything discovered today. Today's the 14th, these are all on the 7th. That is a quick way to scan your download for malware. In other words, if it comes up without finding any malware in the download, okay, the deck's stacked a little bit further in your favor. However, the problem that a lot of people don't understand is simply that not all malware tools actually catch all malware. So it is possible that Windows Defender will miss something that a different malware scanner might catch. And conversely, it's very possible that that different malware scanner might miss something that Microsoft Defender would catch. So what do you do? Well, there's one other thing. If you really are trying to stack the deck even further in your favor, is to go to a site called VirusTotal. VirusTotal.com. And you can see here, you have the option to point it at a URL, do a search, whatever. What we care about here is file. I'm going to choose the file. I'm going to go to my downloads folder, and I'm just going to go ahead and upload this file that I'm not sure about. It's been uploaded and it's been scanned. And you can see here, no security vendors and no sandboxes flag this as malicious. What does that mean? Well, what happened is VirusTotal actually ran this file through 71 different anti-malware scanners, and they all reported that it was safe. Chances are it's safe, but I still have to warn you that especially as new malware is being created every minute of every day, it is possible that malware could actually slip by all 71 scanners. Unlikely, but possible. And that's where we actually come down to the very last recommendation. And that's simply this. Who do you trust? Do you trust where you got the download from? Do you trust whoever it is that sent you the attachment? If you are not 100% sure, if you have any question at all, if it just feels icky, don't run the file. Take additional steps, perhaps, to confirm that it is what you think it is. Ask the sender if they indeed sent it. Don't just reply to the email, but actually type in the email address of who you think it came from and ask them if they sent you an attachment. If they did, great. Then you're trusting their ability to send you something secure. But if they didn't, then it's very possible what you're looking at is spam, and what you're looking at in that attachment is malware. But the bottom line is there is no way to 100% guarantee that the file does not have malware. However, using your own scanner, using tools like VirusTotal, and using your own common sense, you can absolutely stack the deck very much in your favor. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/165375. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.